We're going to cover factoring trinomials of the form ax squared plus bx plus c into two binomials if it can be factored. So this is difficult for lots of students, and there are many different ways people learn to do this, but we'll take an example. Factor 2x squared minus 7x plus 3. So if we're going to do it into two binomials, what we're trying to do is like go back to what it was before it was multiplied out and became 2x squared minus 7x plus 3. So we're going to see. I wonder if it factors. By the way, the first thing you would do is make sure there's no common factor in all three terms. But there is not. So let's see. I know the first term in each parentheses must be 2x squared. Really, there's only one possibility. One of them is going to have to be 2x, and the other one's going to have to be x. Also, in the other parentheses, I'm sorry, in the second term in each parentheses, those two numbers must multiply out to be positive 3. So it's either going to be a 3 here and a 1 here. Those are the only numbers that multiply out to be 3. Or you could have the 1 and the 3 switch places. Now, I didn't put the sign down yet, whether it's positive or negative, but notice the last term's negative. So if the last term's negative, since it's positive, both signs are going to have to be the same sign. Think about that. They're either, to get a positive number when you multiply two things, they're both going to be positive or negative. Now, the middle term's negative, so they certainly can't be both positive. You'd never get negative, so they're going to have to both be negative signs. So they're going to have to both be negative in this case. All right, so let's see if this is the correct factorization. Okay, so we know that we've got the first terms in each. That works out to 2x squared, and the last terms multiplied together give you a positive 3, but the question is the middle term. So let's just check out the middle term. The outer and the inner terms are negative 2x and minus 3x, which is negative 5x, which is not the correct middle term. So this is not correct. So let's, this doesn't work. What about if we had switched the 1 and the 3? Because that's different. They still would both be negatives. Now let's check the middle terms. That gives you a negative 6x. And a minus 1x, which is negative 7x, and that's correct. So that means this is correct. This did not work. What's really important is that you always check by either doing the FOIL method or the box method or out on scratch paper, anything, smiley face method, making sure that when you multiply these out, you really get exactly 2x squared minus 7x plus 3. Be very careful of your signs. Every single detail matters. Here's another one, 5x squared minus 13x minus 6. By the way, when one of the numbers is prime, the first or last term, it makes it a little bit easier because there are not very many choices. The only possibility is 5x and x. On the other hand, we have a lot of choices for this one. It could be a 2 and a 3, a 3 and a 2, a 1 and a 6, or a 6 and a 1. So there are a lot more choices because 6 is not prime. On top of that, the fact that this is negative makes it a little bit harder because also 1's going to be positive and 1's negative. So in this case, if you listed out all the possibility, it's 8 possibilities. I'm not going to list them out, but we'll see as we go through it what might happen. So what am I going to put here? Well, you just have to like try something. So if you want, you could try putting a 6 and a 1. Now, since this is negative, it means they're going to be opposite signs. Because the only way to get a negative 6 if one of these is positive and one of these is negative. So let's just try putting in a plus 6 and a minus 1 and check the middle term. All right, so the outer term is negative 5x. The inner term is plus 6x. And that gives you x, not negative 13. So that did not work. Let's try switching and putting the 1 here and the 6 there. So that's different, correct? Now let's do it. Well, that gives you the outer term is negative 30x and a 1x. That also does not give you negative 13x, so that doesn't work. So I'm just going to write that doesn't work, that doesn't work. Okay, let's try something else. Okay, so it didn't work putting in the 6 or the 1. So let's try different factors. How about the 2 or the 3? So let's do 2 and 3. And we know 1's got to be positive and 1's got to be negative. Opposite sign. So let's put the positive here and the negative here. All right, so we have 5x times negative 3 is negative 15x. And the inner is positive 2x. I'm sorry. Yes, that works. Plus 2x. That does give you negative 13x. Hallelujah. That's our answer. Double check the first terms together multiply out to be 5x squared. Yes. The outer and the inner add up to negative 13x, and the last is negative 6. I want to make a little comment. What if you had, let's go back. Let's go back to this one, and let's say you had tried the plus sign here and the minus sign here. Then I would have had plus 15 and minus 2, correct? And that's 13x. If the only difference is the sign, that means all you need to do is switch signs. Okay? So if you're adding two things together, one's positive and one's negative, and instead of getting the negative 13x, you get positive 13x, when you switch signs, you will get the correct answer. So this is going to be the minus and plus, and that's it. Now, if that wouldn't have worked, I would have maybe put the 3 here and the 2 there, etc. So as you can see, it's sort of a process that, you know, could take a long time. It really depends on what you try first. It depends how many different factors the first coefficient has, how many factors the second coefficient has. The more factors it has, the more things you might have to try. As I said, this actually, if you listed all the possibilities, there would be 8 different things you might have to try. Some problems might be 15 things. So there are other ways to do it, but this is the trial factors method. There is one more thing I just wanted to mention, and that is when you're doing a problem and you're plugging in numbers inside the parentheses, you'll never put a common factor in the same parentheses. For instance, if you were doing this problem, 2x squared minus 5x plus 2, and we're going to start off with a 2x and an x, and a 2 and a 1, you would not put the 2 here, because then whatever's in this parentheses would have a common factor of 2. You wouldn't put a 4 there, a 6 there, anything that has a common factor of 2. So you would at least be sure that it would have to go this way. And in this case, this is pretty simple. Since this is positive, they're going to have the same sign. Both have to be negative, get a negative, and that's your only choice in this particular case, and that actually is the correct factorization. So that one, there's really only one choice for you, since you can't put the 2 in here anyway. Before going on to another video and some other methods, which I think might be easier than trial factors for some of you, a little more systematic and shortcuts, what's really important is that once you factor something, you always check and make sure it really and truly is the correct factorization. So here's some 3 problems I've written here, and I just want you to check, put it on pause, and check to see if that really is the correct factorization. Okay, for the first one. Well, the first term is correct. X times 5x is 5x squared, and the last term is correct, the negative 14. The inner term is a negative 35x, and the outer term is a plus 2x, and that is a negative 33x, not a positive 33x. So the answer to this is no. That's the wrong factorization. And since the only difference is the sign of the middle term, the correct factorization would happen to be x plus 7 and 5x minus 2. Let's go on to the next one. The first terms do you multiply out to be 18x squared, and the last terms multiply out to be 4. So the inner term and the outer term is negative 3x and minus 24x. That's correct. That gives me negative 27x. Let's do this last one. 3x times 2x gives you the 6x squared. 1 times negative 3 is negative 3, and the answer here is positive 3. So, automatically, this one's no, even before checking the middle term. And that's it. Go on to the next video for